This is the last lecture of this chapter 4. Now in this lecture, we want to convert galvanometer into fully functioning ammeter and voltmeter. Okay, you know that ammeter is a device to measure the current and galvanometer is device to detect the current and voltmeter is to device to measure the potential difference between the two points. So in first case, let me convert a galvanometer into ammeter. So how it can be converted? Galvanometer can be converted into fully functioning ammeter by connecting it with a very small resistance in series, in parallel. Okay, in parallel. Please remember, fully functioning ammeter by connecting a very small resistance, and this very small resistance is also called as shunt resistance. Please remember, shunt resistance and shunting. Whenever you see shunting, in some book they may write by shunting it with the galvanometer. Shunting means to connect galvanometer or to connect any electrical component in parallel with a very small resistance. That is called shunting. So sometimes it may be written as shunting. Okay, by fully functioning ammeter by shunting a galvanometer. Okay, it can also be written. Shunting means connection of very small resistance with any electrical component in parallel. Here the electrical component is my galvanometer. Okay, or shunting or shunt resistance. Very small resistance is also called shunt resistance in parallel with the galvanometer. So this is how it looks like, but this diagram may differ. Okay, in some book it may be just given like this. This is your galvanometer and you will get this. Okay, this is and this are same. Okay, for easy I have done like this, and this is the symbol of galvanometer. See, galvanometer you can just write G and positive, negative, or you can just write arrow here and write G. Okay, this is my galvanometer. So here let me have a current I which is going in this direction, and in the third chapter we have studied, okay, this will be divided by Kirchhoff's junction rule. So this is I, say IG is going in this direction, and in this direction let us write IRS. IRS means small resistance, small resistance, or you can simply or S. Okay, if you write capital S, that will be enough, but I will just write resistance small. Now this time here is how much I R S is equal to how much, can you tell me? Okay, total, how much is the total? It was coming I and IG came here, from I, IG gone here, then how much will be remaining in this current? I minus IG will be equal to IRS, isn't it? I minus IG. Are you getting this or not? Yes, you should always get. Why? Because from I, IG is gone. Okay, it was 100, and from 100, let me write there 70 gone. Then how much is remaining? This is 100 minus 70, that is equal to 30. Okay, so similarly, from IG gone here, how much is remaining here? RS, IRS, and the which is equal to I minus IG. Okay, 100 minus 70. Now this is in parallel, isn't it? Isn't it? So let me have, here I have got RG. What is RG? RG is the galvanometer resistance or the resistance of the galvanometer coil. Okay, if RG is resistance of galvanometer. Galvanometer, okay, you write full. And then this is in parallel, then what will happen? Voltage drop in this galvanometer and in this resistance will be same because this is in parallel. Okay, since RG and RS, that is a small resistance, are in parallel, So therefore, voltage drop in galvanometer will be equal to voltage drop in RS. Okay. Then how much is voltage drop? You know V is equal to IR. Everyone knows Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. Okay. So then this will be how much? VZ. Here VZ is IR. What is I? IZ. IZ. And what is R? That is resistance is RZ. Will be equal to V equals to IR. So IZ into RZ. And here it will be how much? Current is IRS into what is resistance is RS. So this is the resistance. But what I am doing here, what we are doing here, we are finding the value of small resistance. I have said this, to convert a galvanometer into ammeter, we have to connect a small resistance in parallel with the galvanometer. And how much should be that resistance? How much should be that small resistance to connect in parallel so that this galvanometer will be converted into a ammeter? Okay, so I am finding RS. So now what I can do is then, or this is IZ, RZ is equal to how much is IRS? This much, okay, I minus IZ and into RS, and I want to find RS, okay? So I can just write RS into I minus IZ is equal to IZ RZ, very simple. Or what I can write is RS is equal to IZ RZ divided by I minus of IZ. So this is the value of small resistance which should be connected in the parallel to convert galvanometer into ammeter. Okay, so now let us convert a galvanometer into voltmeter. So what is a voltmeter? It is a device to measure potential difference between two points. So voltmeter, okay, it can be converted into fully functioning voltmeter by connecting it with a large resistance in series with galvanometer. So I have to connect a large resistance in series with galvanometer. For an example, so let me have this point A and this point B, and in between this A and B I want to find the potential difference, okay, using a galvanometer. Then how I can find, how I can make whole system a voltmeter? Then I have to connect a large resistance in series with the galvanometer so that this system will become now voltmeter. This whole system is now have become a voltmeter. So let me consider the current here. This current, okay, is my IZ, and here is also IZ, here is also IZ. Why IZ? Because this and this are in series, and in series the current will remain same. Okay, I am not considering this current. So from this current, okay, from this point the current, some current will go down if I use voltmeter, but I am not considering the current here. I am considering the current only in this line, okay, from this and this. IZ, 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 because in series the current will remain same. Let, okay, if I will write, if RZ is resistance as same as the previous one of galvanometer, write it full. If RZ is the resistance of galvanometer, then between point A and B there is a potential difference V. Okay, if you want to measure the potential difference A and B, then there is potential difference V. Okay, so between A and B, let the potential difference be V plus 1. Okay, so therefore V is equal to, I know IR, okay, We know that V is equal to IR, but this is in series, isn't it? Then we know V is equal to IR, or this V will be how much? This is in series, then this will become IG RG plus IG and R. Okay, because we know that V is equal to I. Okay, this is therefore, this is we know. Okay, we know V is equal to IR. Then this V will be how much? This will be VG plus VR. Okay, so this will be how much? V equals to VG plus VR from Kirchhoff's rule. Then how much is VG? This is IG RG and this is IG R, because current is same, IG and IG current. I know V is equal to IR, so IG RG, IR again, IG R. So here I want to find again the large resistance. What should be the value of that large resistance so that when connected in series, this galvanometer will become a voltmeter? Okay, and I want to find that value of voltmeter. So how can I do this? Here all out, or I will get this V and equal to IG is common, then I will get RG plus R, right? Because IG is common, then what we can write, if it is so, or you bring this down, V by IG is here equal to RG plus R. And what I want? I want to find the value of R. Then, or I will just write V by IG. I will bring this RG here. So this will become minus of RG is equal to R. So what is the value of R then? The value of R should be R is equal to V by IG minus of RG. So this is how you can convert a galvanometer into voltmeter and ammeter. So this is very important. It is asked in some time. Okay, it is all, not always, but it is also asked sometime. Even it is asked in the some competitive examinations. Thank you.